So, Gary, straight back to work with your next fight, probably now in December. That's a pretty tough schedule.
Yeah, but I think it goes with the territory, as to say. Because things are getting harder now, so it's best to keep training and fighting as often as possible.
So who's it likely to be against?
There's been a mention of a Mark Wills who recently beat Derek Williams, a Commonwealth champion, or maybe Trevor Burbick, or opponent of that sort.
So you've got to keep knocking over these big names now.
That's right, yeah. It's getting harder. It's not that easy anymore, is it?
Well, the bookies are quoting you tonight at 10-1 to hold any version of the world heavyweight title within 2 years. How do you feel about that?
Well, they're good odds. They're very good odds. That means I've got a chance. At least it's not 100-1 or something like that.
But your goal is Tyson, what now, in about 4 or 5 fights' time?
Yeah, 4 or 5 fights, roughly 18 months. It all depends on how it goes and what sort of opponents we can get and the time schedule we get on them.
Now, you were your heaviest ever last night because I gather you couldn't train properly.
No, I injured my groin playing football, and so that put the groundwork out for about 3 weeks. And then about 2 weeks before, I wasn't able to spar because I had a cut eye. But they're things that they wouldn't have been mentioned if I'd have lost, but now I can say them, and that can explain why I went into a health farm and came out heavier than I went in.
What are the lessons learned from last night, then?
I think I proved to myself, or I proved to the public, I can take a punch, which is not a good thing to prove because you just don't want to take them full stop. But I think it showed that I had the guts to go in with someone of that class, and it showed that I wasn't out of my depth at all.
What about someone of the class of Bruno? Because he's hinted at getting back into the ring. It's a fight the public, as you well know, would love to see. Now, what are the prospects?
I think we should have a vote on whether they actually want to see that, because a lot of people don't even want Frank to fight again. And it's only the media that are trying to encourage this fight, which I think is wrong. Your job is to talk to people, not to encourage them to fight each other.
But it could earn you a lot of money, couldn't it?
Yeah, but sometimes money's not everything. You must have some principles in life, and you can't do everything for money. But let me just say this. If the fight between me and Frank Bruno was made, what we'd have to do, we'd have to spar together because we'd be ideal sparring for each other. And then in between the rounds of the fight, George Francis and Frank Black, they'd have to have 30 minutes in each corner. And the only way to make it really fair is to have Terry Lawless as the referee. And then we could have Mike Barrett, Mickey Duff and Jarvis Assir, they can be the judges. If we can arrange it that way, then I'm sure the fight has got a possibility of taking place.
It's not going to happen, is it?
No. Not like that anyway.
Gary, good to talk to you. Wish you well for the future.
OK, Graham, thank you.